Hey guys, I am gonna give you a quick rundown of my camera gear setup as well as how I hang everything in a tree. I was hunting this morning, didn't see anything, so I figured this would be a good time to do it. It's a little windy, so hopefully nothing hears me talking, but so first things first, I was already starting to pack up a little bit. So I've got this strap bow hook, and it's got three of these hook things, and I hang like a rangefinder or something off of these. If I don't need them, I'll push them to the back side of the tree where I'm not going to be shooting. And then on this side is where I hang my bow. Typically I obviously turn it the other way, but I just put my quiver back on, so that's why it's hanging this way. And then I've got a GoPro that is mounted on a magnet, which is made by Painted Arrow, I believe. It's a little magnet deal, and it's nice because this just comes off if I need it to, but it's a pretty strong magnet, so it's not gonna just like fall off. So yeah, that's that. Obviously, now I'm in a saddle, so I've got my tether. I set this about forehead height. And then, let's see what's next. And then I have another tether that I use to hang my backpack from. And I really like these. This is called the Duck Kong. It's like the carabiner clip. To easily, like if I need to make this go higher, I just pull on the rope, and then I can just pull on this to lower it, and it's a lot easier than these knots. So, I mean, this also works, but I prefer using these just for convenience reasons. But anyway, this is the tethered FAS pack. I love this thing. It's honestly really awesome for how small it is, and the camera gear that I have fits in there pretty perfect, so I really don't have any complaints about it. And then I've got a knee cushion that I just strap around. I either loop it around the camera arm or just around the tree. I think you can honestly just get these at like Walmart, you know, just cushions. I have two for extra padding, and that's so I can lean my knees against it. And then for my camera, my main setup, this is the Sony A6300 with a 18 to 200 millimeter lens. And I think that's honestly a really perfect lens for archery hunting. You know, I can film nice and close, but also like if they're out kind of a little ways, it's still good too. This is just a shotgun mic that I've got. To be honest, I don't know what brand it is. I used to have a Rode shotgun mic, and it was like with the puffy on, and it was totally fine. The only reason I switched to this is because it sits up a little bit higher, and my other one was real low profile, and anytime I would adjust the zoom or focus on this, you could hear it in the mic, it'd go. So I wanted something that wasn't against the lens, and so far it's been fine. And then let's see what else. I think that's about it for that. This camera arm is one that the reason I haven't talked about it much already is because it's not, I don't want to say it's not on the market, but I'm friends with the guy who created it, and it's honestly, it's pretty good for how small it is, but there was kind of a falling out with the manufacturer and the guy that I'm friends with, so I don't really advertise it, not because I'm trying to gatekeep the information, I just don't really think that it's for sale. So truly the only reason I have this arm is because I'm friends with the guy that made it. So I can't really tell you guys just because I don't think you can buy it. But anyway, it's just a real compact camera arm. If you guys are new to filming and need some recommendations, I would try maybe Fourth Arrow. To be completely honest with you, I don't think there's really a like great camera arm that's on the market. So it's kind of unfortunate. I think there's a lot of brands that need to maybe step up and try to make something because there's a need for it, obviously. But anyway, that's my camera arm. I'm not going to talk anymore about it. And then obviously I've just got my tethered set up. This is a Predator platform. This is just a standard size that's pretty much fits 2 feet. They have an XL version also if that's something that you maybe need a little more room, but usually the point of it is to be small and compact, so I don't really worry about it. And it's one of those, like, you can hang off the side, you know, if you need to swing around or whatever. And then I've got the One sticks, which are the lightest sticks ever. They literally are a pound a piece. Just going down the tree there. And this is just my bow rope, so I dropped my hat. So anyway, this is kind of what it looks like. I'm in the Phantom saddle. And I know it looks like a lot, but I promise it's really not. Like, everybody thinks, like, oh, you carry too much in the woods, or it looks like too much going on, which it's not. Like, I don't ever have it get in the way. I mean, when I draw my bow, it's out here. It's not right here, you know. It's not against me. Your bow's out here. So, you know, I'm not, like, doing this. I'm literally, like, if I have to, I will turn away. Shoot outwards. So that's my setup. And then last, you guys are currently watching this video through my Canon G7X, and it's just a little vlog camera that already, the lens doesn't come off or anything. It's 8.8 to 36.8 millimeter, and it's really awesome for just having my second angle. I'll typically set it up either right on my backpack, or if I'm in a tree that has extra branches, I'll put it around a branch. It has a little bendy tripod, which I'll attach a quick clip so you guys can see it. But anyway, that's the setup. And it's worked pretty well for me. I try to be as efficient as I can, but I feel like everybody's like, oh, you bring a lot of stuff in the woods. And yeah, yes, I do. But the reality is, like, I need all of it if I'm gonna film for you guys. So it's fine. I don't mind it. I couldn't even tell you, like, what my pack weighs. I don't really know. The camera gear really truly is the heaviest part of everything, so I don't know, and I don't care. I need it all, so I just put it all in my pack and I put it on and I don't complain about it. Is what it is. But anyway, also, I really want to touch on anybody who's new to filming. I don't recommend my setup necessarily. The vlog camera's, like, okay, but I don't recommend the Sony a6300. There's just a lot of features. I run everything in full manual, but that's just because I've had a lot of practice. You will mess up on deer if you run a DSLR like I have. It's gonna happen. So I recommend, if you're starting out especially, get some sort of handy cam. There's all different kinds of handy cams in different brands and different budgets. So just figure out whatever you wanna spend. You don't have to break the bank to get decent camera gear these days. So, you know, figure out your budget and look into the handy cams. And honestly, like, a GoPro even is super easy to use. You just press the button and it starts recording. So, yeah, I just wanted to touch on that because I don't recommend my setup. My setup is difficult to deal with, especially having 3 cameras. So if you can just get 1 or maybe 2, then I think that's a good place to start. I didn't see anything. Actually, I saw some fawns this morning, but I was trying to shoot a doe, but nothing came close enough, and pretty slow just overall. I think think I need to move, so that's what I'm gonna do. But I hope you guys liked my little rundown. This is about how I set up every time. It just depends on the tree, honestly. Like, if there's branches in the way, I might have to set up differently. And ideally, my camera is on one side of the tree and my bow is on the other, but it doesn't always work out that way. So, thanks for watching. Hopefully the next time I see you guys, I'll have a deer down.